In this lecture, we'll study properties of DFT. Let's consider the first property, that is linearity property. In linearity property, if we consider, say, x1 of n and x2 of n are two discrete sequences. If we take DFT of the discrete signal x1 of n, that is n point DFT, that is n point DFT of x1 of n is, suppose, say, x1 of k, and we have another sequence x2 of n. Similarly, the n point DFT of this x2 of n is, say, x2 of k. Now, I will multiply x1 of n with some constant a, that is a x1 of n. I will multiply another constant, say, b with x2 of n, that is b x2 of n. If I add these two sequences, now I will call this entire signal as, say, x of n. Now, if I take n point DFT of this, the result will be a x1 of k plus b x2 of k. This is the definition of linearity property. We'll try to prove this. We know that DFT of any discrete signal x of n is given by summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n, that is the same x of n, w n power n k, where k varies from 0 to n minus 1. But x of n is nothing but a x1 of n plus b x2 of n. A x1 of n plus b x2 of n is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Here we have x of n, which is nothing but a x1 of n plus b x2 of n. A x1 of n plus b x2 of n, whole thing is multiplied with w n power n k. Now further I will simplify. I will multiply w n power n k with each term. I can get is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 a x1 of n w n power n k plus b x2 of n w n power n k. Now I will separately use this summation to each term, that is summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 a x1 of n w n power n k plus summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 b x2 of n w n power n k. So here a is constant, I will take out of summation, that is a summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x1 of n w n power n k plus b, which is constant, summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x2 of n w n power n k. At the beginning we have considered that DFT of x1 of n is x1 of k. Therefore, this is the DFT expression for x1 of k, that is nothing but x1 of k plus b. This is DFT expression for x2 of n. So DFT of x2 of n is x2 of k. So that is nothing but DFT of a x1 of n plus b x2 of n. Thus, linearity property is proved. Now consider the second property, that is circular time shift property. Suppose the DFT of any discrete signal x of n is, say, x of k, that is, if x of n is x of k, then dft of x of n minus m is equal to, this is known as circular shift, w n power m k into x of k for k less than or equal to n or greater than or equal to 0. That is, k varies from 0 to n minus 1. Here x of n minus m, n is nothing but circular shift. We will try to prove this property. We will start with IDFT. We know that IDFT of any sequence x of k is equal to x of n. It can be represented as 1 over n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n power minus n k, where n varies from 0 to n minus 1. This is IDFT expression. Now I will replace n by n minus m. That is, replace n by n minus m so that I can represent it as x of n minus m is equal to 1 over n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n. So here we have n, it should be replaced by n minus m. That is, minus n minus m into k. So we know that time shift is circular, since time shift is circular, so this above equation can be represented as x of n minus m, circular time shift is represented like this, is equal to 1 over n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n power minus n k dot, I can write w n power m k. So here I have written the same expression. So now observe this equation. Here we have written IDFT of x of k can be represented as 1 over n summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k with the Tudel factor w n power minus n k. So this is the expression or IDFT of x of k. Similar way, here I can say, if we concentrate this entire expression, so here this term is IDFT of this term is nothing but x of n minus m. Therefore, I can write x of n minus m is nothing but IDFT of x of k w n power m into k. So now I can say IDFT of this term is equal to this one, is nothing but DFT of this term is equal to this term. Therefore, I can write DFT of x of n minus m is equal to x of k w n power m k into x of k. Therefore, this property is proved. That is, x of n minus m, its n point DFT is equal to w n power m k into x of k. Thus, this property is proved. Thank you for watching.